Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Where do we begin? There's so much to go over today.
Well, I certainly did destroy my breakfast. I couldn't eat because of what was being played in the office. Now, I usually, you know, I could watch anything. I don't care for the most part. And while we're eating in the office, there's not anything too disgusting playing. But this morning, I reached my limit. Tumor face.
Well, tumor face, yes. I came into work today, and I had to tell the guys immediately. The Learning Channel is pretty much P.T. Barnum.
Yeah.
In the year 2008. They find the freaks that are living among us around the world, and they do stories on them. And all under the guise that we're learning something, because it's the Learning Channel.
The Learning Channel. Learning is right in the name.
No, it's the Freak Channel.
Yeah.
You know, you get the twins that are connected by their skulls,
mm-hmm.
and you get, like Wolf Boy. And last night they had Man Without Face. Go to YouTube right now
mm-hmm.
and type in Man Without Face if you're near a computer.
Is your assignment.
Yes, and we will link this later today on onaradio.com. So I was bored yesterday. I didn't feel like learning about politics and this dumb presidential race that is among us. So I started flipping around the channels for the first time in a while. And I stopped on the Learning Channel to meet Man Without Face. How amazing is that, Jimmy?
It's awful.
It's so disgusting. Than had a great one. He goes, if he was a Dick Tracy villain, he'd be Grape Face. His face looks like a bunch of grapes.
But they're tumors.
Yeah. And they're so huge on his face you can't see any facial features.
Is that his wife and kids?
I don't know. I don't know. I think he's got a girlfriend.
He's got a girlfriend.
Or that's his sister. I don't know. I was too distracted by the tumors. The tumor or the tumors...
Oh. God.
Connect to make one big tumor that looks like a face in front of his face.
But
right?
It's a big, goofy face.
Well, it doesn't look like a face, but it's a big blob the size of his entire head that's in front of his face. I'm trying to describe this, and the color is kind of like liverish.
Yeah, reddish.
Kind of like a liver.
Every minute they're in the house with him, they have to just be looking at him going, yuck.
Exactly.
It's awful.
Yuck. How do you eat around him?
I don't know.
You can't.
You think the guy has bad breath?
Who could tell? It probably gets caught behind the tumors.
You can't wash everything in there. Like, you can't just wash your face and your face is washed.
Yeah.
You got to lift up each individual bumpy tumor and Q-tip out the face tumor cheese.
Well, the other thing is he has to lift up. Yeah. The other thing is,
enjoy your breakfast, Jimmy.
The other thing, he has to lift up this whole mess just to breathe.
Yep.
Because the nasal passages get all clogged up, so he's got to lift it up, and that gets tiring. So he kind of waits until he has to breathe again, and then he lifts it up for a little while, and then drops it down again. This thing is amazing, and the guy was too scared to go to a doctor, or there was something going.
Oh, God, I can't even look at that.
You could see one eye poking out of the side. But the rest is, how do you describe it? Did we describe it okay?
He looks like a Star Wars character.
Yeah.
It looks like, Thanos, it looks like a guy. The back of his head's normal. Picture two ears and a bushel of grapes. That is literally what he looks like.
Yeah. Big grapes and plums just stuck to his face, all rough and ravaged.
Of course, he doesn't live in America because we got fine medical in this country. These people are always somewhere else, man.
Yeah.
Where this goes
untreated.
Untreated.
It's disgusting.
Unchecked.
Oh, my God.
So he makes a movie about his life because he's so sick of people, you know, running away. The people literally run away scared when they see this guy.
He's a Muppet.
Yeah, so he made a 20-minute movie, and then he decided to show the movie in the town square. So the same people that run away scared will see that he's not an animal. And only about 20 or 30 people showed up. They
hilarious. That
yeah.
He was a bust.
Yeah.
He had a big premiere party.
Yeah, he pretty much had a premiere in the middle of town. 20 or 30 people showed up, and that was it. He was able to tell 20 or 30 people that he wasn't an animal. The rest of them are still scared, S-less of this guy.
Chasing him with torches.
Yeah,
that's what they should be doing, pitchforks. It's kill it.
He just wants to be a movie star. That's all it is.
A movie star.
He makes it like a plot about.
Yeah.
You know, he's saving the world. He's carrying a nuclear weapon shaped like grapes in his face away from the school. Yuck.
Yuck. That's all you want to say.
Yuck. It's amazing. It looks like intestines.
Yes.
It looks like kind of. Yeah. I'm trying to like something, really give the visual to the
guts.
People out there.
Guts. He has a face full of guts.
And know what? People are finding it, and all I'm seeing on instant feedback, Chunk One from Pleasant City, Ohio, he writes, "Oh my effing God," and just a ton of exclamation points.
Yeah.
We'll have this linked on onaradio.com later. We got audio. You want to hear some audio of this guy?
Yes.
This wasn't how we were going to start today, but I'm flipping around before I went to bed. Guess who had nightmares all night, by the
way?
Yeah,
that's a good thing to doze off to.
And if you're bored, you're at home and you're flipping around, you have nothing to watch, right? Just go to the Learning Channel. And if you got DVR, just look, because in the middle of the night, they get really freaky.
Yep.
With these people, these circus. They're circus freaks, but we're not allowed to display them anymore.
Ugh.
I miss the days where you could pay your...
Oh, that guy would have been behind wall in a tent with some carnival barker just screaming out, "See the amazing grape face man," or something.
Yeah, but the do-gooders, you know, they're taking income away from these people. That's what they're doing in the end. This guy would go on tour and make a fortune. But yeah. The do-gooders like, "Oh, you can't do that. You can't display humans that,
show
that,
grape
don't,
face.
That don't look normal."
I don't feel bad for him.
No.
Why?
I don't feel bad for this guy at all.
Oh, you're reading up on him a little
yes,
bit, Jimmy?
I am.
What do you got? What did you learn from the Learning Channel?
A Jehovah's Witness who for decades refused all surgery on his horrific facial disfigurement has been given hope by a British doctor with new medical technology. Unwilling to accept a blood transfusion, Jose Rana has allowed this bloody tumor that first appeared on his lip in adolescence to obliterate almost all of his face. So he's had opportunities for years and years and years.
So it started with a little thing on his lip?
Yep.
Oh, my God.
A little
God.
Thing. Well, you see the picture, the early picture of him? He looks like, meh, meh, see? Meh. He just got this big, fat lip.
Yeah. He was a mess to begin with.
Meh.
You know, looking at his face, you know, it didn't do that much damage, this tumor. Because you see the before picture. We got the before and after picture. We'll throw that up on onaradio.com as well. All right. Some audio from this fine show I checked out last night.
It's midday. And Jose Mestre is waking up. So when I wake up, I wash my face.
Why? And then I go back to bed because it's nighttime.
Why bother washing your face?
Wash it with a train.
Why would you wash your face? What is that really going to do?
Yeah, he's washing his tumors.
Right, you're washing...
You're going to wash your tumors?
You're basically washing the inside of your body.
Ugh.
Who would do that?
Just there. I just picture him with, like, if he really did have good hygiene, with a Q-tip, just getting in there.
Yeah.
All the nooks and crannies.
Yeah.
I wash my face. Then I get dressed. I go and have breakfast. Make a snack. I try to speak as little as possible. It's because I start dribbling.
Wait, I got it. Hold on, we're not doing this, John.
My friend doesn't like you. I don't like you either.
But he doesn't like to talk because he starts dribbling.
Dribbling.
What, does he think that's going to turn people off?
Yeah, ew.
Right. Get it?
Yeah.
Swamp thing. A little drool on the shirt is not really going to hurt your chances with that girl.
That's not really our problem
Swamp
here.
Thing.
That's not the thing we're really worried about.
Ugh. Possible. It's because I start dribbling. And sometimes the veins start to come out.
Jose
struggles with the simplest of day-to-day tasks as the tumor obscures his sight.
Wow.
He said, "I'm going to be late for my singing engagement."
I am your father.
That, yeah, he sounds like this guy could do a one-man Star Wars act. He does sound like Darth.
Darth, yuck.
I am your father.
Dude. All right. Well, he has to lift the tumor to eat and drink, people.
Dude, I can't. Literally, I've watched Two Girls, One Cup. I could eat pudding.
Yeah, yeah.
I cannot eat my breakfast.
Literally. Don't worry. I was eating the bagel, and it's a bagel. It's not really anything that looks like the food, his face or his tumor. If you're eating, like, I don't know, blood sausage in the morning, that could be a problem. But
and don't worry, we'll get the bad taste out of your mouth when we talk about how Obama's wife decided not to help Stevie Wonder after he fell on his face. Oh, my God, is that a funny, funny video. Anyway, all right, we'll get to that in a bit, but more from Tumor Face.
Mealtimes are difficult for Josie, as he has to lift the growth to eat and drink.
Yes, well.
When I drink on one side with a straw. Since he was a teenager, Josie has been losing his face to this life-threatening tumor, smothering his lips, nose, and one of his eyes. It's about 33 centimeters long and weighs around 3 kilograms.
His voice when that was playing is perfect. How much does that weigh? And can we do the math?
Look, Tumor Face, I just need a little more time.
Is there more audio than talking with that?
Oh, yeah.
No, that's 12 perfect.
12 pounds. The tumor is 12 pounds.
Oh. Hey, we don't serve your kind in here. Sorry, Tumor Face, you have to leave. Yes, it is disgusting, Artu. I don't know what the hell it is. It's frightening me. Yes, it does look like Jabba the Hutt's genitals.
Bowie Man saying it looks like when Cloverfield was attacking.
Oh.
Yeah.
The little things jump off his face.
Yeah. You want to hear more?
Of course.
All right. Please.
All right, get rid of that for a second there, and we'll go back to...
Until his voice kicks in.
Yeah, he likes... Perfect. Yeah, as soon as you hear his voice, you got to go there. He likes to go to a square, you know, the town square, to sit and hang out, and then he gets really angry when people stare at him.
Yeah.
You know...
Well, come on.
Dude.
Cut us some slack.
Dude, humans will stare at a mole that's just a little too big. Of course you're going to stare at this.
In the afternoon, Josie travels into Lisbon to pass time in his favorite place, the Praça do Rossio Square, and watch the world go by. But some find it hard not to stare.
I get upset because the people, they come here, take a photo, don't say anything, and go. And go. What do I want? I want to be able to talk to my friends, talk to everyone, and be able to cure my eyes. I want to travel, to see what I've not seen.
Jose's thoughts are interrupted by a member of the public trying to take a picture.
This is not the photo wrecker you're looking for.
Hey, Kevin from Connecticut has a great observation. The ugly woman with him could use maybe a 7 or 8 pound face tumor. Yeah, you don't get any sympathy from this radio show. That's why
awful.
We'll never be syndicated to 200 radio stations.
Yeah,
there's just not a huge audience for this crap. We have no sympathy for this.
By a member of the public trying to take a picture. Jose has had enough. He leaves the square with his nephew.
Yeah.
What does he expect?
Yeah, I mean, come on.
He should wear the biggest, ugliest yellow hat with a flower on it. Try to distract.
You know, we haven't had a Photoshop contest in a while.
Yeah, big yellow hat like Sandy Duncan in Roots.
We're going to have to Photoshop some stuff on this guy. When you see the picture later, if you haven't seen it already, oh my goodness.
Yeah, it is just like he threw up his insides.
So he's in the town square, someone's taking a picture, and he gets very upset, and he leaves, and he goes home.
Upset by the day's events, Jose becomes angry and frustrated. He's trying to prove he's not invisible. He feels that people see only his condition and not the man behind the face. That night, Jose explains his frustrations to his sister, Guido.
Stay on target. Almost there.
Han Solo.
He's saying that there are days where he feels sad and annoyed.
Days?
If it wasn't for the blood that's inside, he would get a knife and cut it off because he gets so desperate.
Yeah, well.
I like the fact that he has days that he's sad and annoyed.
Yeah.
That's as bad as it gets.
I know.
Mild irritation, he's on his period. Oh. He feels fat.
The second you find your mouth, put a shotgun barrel in it.
He goes to blow his brains out, he shoots his ear off.
Oops, my baby. I never was very good at aiming.
He dribbles into the barrel, wets the shell, it doesn't go off. That's his life.
Every Christmas is torture. Oh, another hockey mask.
David W. from Jersey City writes, Star Wars, Revenge of the Sith. Oh, we can make money off this guy. Get him to America. Here's him just talking.
Look, I know, Greedo.
Well,
so bad for him. He wouldn't go for. He refused all surgery for years.
Yeah.
Well, that's what you get.
What a bad Jehovah's Witness he must have been.
I mean, guys in general, we're scared of doctors. But if you see something that's a little out of control, you're running to a doctor.
A little out of control.
Well, it started out as a little out of control, right?
I don't know. That picture of his lip, it's pretty much over by then.
Well, look like
you're gonna do with that thing.
Look like you got punched in the lip.
Mm.
And that's how we start today. We're gonna get that video up on onaradio.com.
Oh yeah.
And now someone is bringing to our attention that there's a guy that's called Tree Man.
Tree Man.
He's the Asian dude.
You've seen Tree Man?
It's he makes this guy look like Rudy Valentino. Tree Man is a goose. By the way, I love the fact that we also have an article on this guy, and it says he's become something of a local celebrity, a notoriety he does not always seem to resent, unable to find work or a girlfriend. I think it's hilarious that he's actually out looking.
He still has hope that he's going to find a girlfriend.
For a chick.
Holy crap, look at Tree Man.
I wasn't thinking of him, there's another guy.
Oh my God, look at Tree Man.
That's just not even human.
Are those flies on it?
What is that?
What is that?
What?
It looks like when Stephen King was Jordy Verrill, and he went to the meteor and got some meteor crap on him. Big lunkhead, always in, always bad. I ought to take it up to college.
You got to see Tree Man. I know this is radio, but... His hands, how do you explain that?
It looks like
the roots of a tree.
And he's smoking with them.
He's smoking. He just set himself on fire.
Eric, why were there spiders on him? There's massive hands.
He should have two hobbits on his back.
I want to make cookies on him.
His feet looks like he stepped in elephant you-know-what.
Yeah.
And then couldn't get the elephant you-know-what off his feet. That's what his feet looks like. Just massive, just, like, stuff.
Those are third world diseases. We have, like...
That's what I said earlier.
We have wacky American diseases, you know.
You don't see
anorexia, bulimia, things like that. That's kind of that disease that happens down in South America.
Yeah. Proving God doesn't want you.
No. God hates those countries.
Yeah. So we'll link Tree Man to onaradio.com later today as well. That is disgusting.
Wow.
An Asian guy who I don't remember his name, obviously, and he has a massive, massive tumor, and he goes for surgery. Can we find that? Did the Asian dude? Do you know who he is, Travis?
Oh, that is so bad.
Yeah, Tree Man has. It looks like tree stumps, like from the when it goes the roots, the tree roots coming off his hands and his feet. Oh yeah, that guy. You see the other dude?
Yeah, that guy's hysterical. Well, by hysterical, I mean gross and disgusting and unlookatable.
All right, we got to take a quick break. We'll find... Oh, there he is. I thought... all right.
Wow.
It looks like his face is melting.
That's after surgery.
What do you mean?
I believe that's
after... That's an improvement?
Really? Yeah. What did he look like before?
Not good. Not good.
Second operation. That's his second operation.
Let's find the before picture. Oof.
Oh my God, oh my God. How do you explain that one?
I can't.
He looks like a giant, it looks like a giant penis.
You just gotta be honest, it does.
With a little hairdo on it. Eating some soup.
Well, a giant penis that has a problem. It's all you know what.
A mess.
It's all.
Yeah.
He doesn't have this. He doesn't have much of this. He has a lot of this.
Doesn't have a lot of what it takes to really do some action.
He's got the Darth Vader part.
Yeah. All right, we're going to take a break. It's the Opie and Anthony Show. This is how we begin today. Terrific.